Hey there, everybody, it's AirPirateCid, and welcome back to more Let's Play Pokemon Fire Red. In the last episode, I got Trogdor the Burninator. And I think I just now fought Helen Keller, because what she said made absolutely no sense. And also, the reason why I'm going to go ahead and cut out the trainer battles here is because they're very, very easy to defeat. They simply use Ghastlies or Haunters, which is Ghost and Poison, which means that they're weak to Psychic, they're weak to Ghost, they're weak to Dark, and that's about it, because Ghastly and Haunter has Levitate, which means that they're immune to ground attacks, unless you're playing the original Red, Blue, and Yellow, in which case go for using ground type attacks. It's super effective. Anyways, I just now ran into a random battle. If you try going through this tower before without the Silph Scope, everything that you would run into would be an unidentified ghost, and you cannot attack it or do anything to it. All you can hear is just the Pokemon cry, and that's it. Cannot attack it or do anything to it. And I went ahead, and I fought every single trainer in this Pokemon Tower, just so where I don't have to edit them out later. Alright, moving on. We're now on the third floor, or fourth floor, I forget. Yeah, step in this little circle, and it's a purify zone, and she explains, yeah, she purified the space. This is the only dungeon with a little healing circle right there that will automatically heal all of your party, and you will not run into anything there. So those of you who are familiar with, like, Final Fantasy IV, for example, like the little circles that they have in that game, I cannot remember what they are, or what the name of them is, but you could use like a tent there or something to heal up. It's essentially the same thing, only you don't have to use a tent in this game. Oh well, alright, we're almost at the end of this place. Hooray! Okay, here we go, required fight. Be gone, intruders. Oh shiz, it's a ghost! Quick, let's call Bill Murray and the Ghostbusters! Nah, I'm just joking. Yeah. Using the Silph Scope, you find out it is a female Marowak. Just to forewarn you now, because I remember trying it as a child, you cannot catch this Marowak with a Pokeball or a Great Ball or a Master Ball or whatever. Actually, I've never tried using a Master Ball on it because I never really cheated for one this early in the game. So I wonder if a Master Ball would work, or if it would just still fail epically and you just wasted a Master Ball. Oh well, all you can do is just simply defeat this Marowak, and that's it. Come on, Marowak, faint already. Pass on into the afterlife, be gone from this world! Ah, I thought that said Boomerang for a minute there. I was gonna think, whoa, that's wrong. Alright, there we go. Pass on from this life, Marowak, and be gone! Be at peace, be at rest. Go to hell, where you belong. Okay, well, maybe it's not going to hell. I don't know if Pokemon go to hell or heaven because their evolution and, yeah, whatever. I'm gonna fight all these trainers off screen, so be right back. Ah, I believe I am getting away with this because you're Team Rocket and you're lame ass. And whenever you defeat the Team Rocket members, you rescue Mr. Fuji! Which actually kind of reminds me of the Mount Fuji. I think it's like a water bottle brand or something like that. Hello, the king! Now let's talk to Mr. Fuji again. Talk to him. Like I just now said, you get the Poke Flute, which means we can now... A, you do not have to use any awakenings or anything like that in battle. If your Pokemon gets put to sleep, you could just use the Poke Flute and it will wake them up. Or at least I think it will. And the second use for the Poke Flute is, well, we'll find out here in a second. Whenever we go down here to find that Snorlax from earlier. Woo! There it is. Alrighty then, it's time to go ahead and use the Poke Flute on this Snorlax. Yes, I want to use that damnable Poke Flute. Also, I'm just going to speed up this battle really quick, so enjoy some good old 8-bit music. Alrighty then, we just now caught Snorlax with a Pokeball, yes! Alrighty then, it is not satisfied unless if it eats over 880 pounds. Huh. Okay, well I have the perfect nickname for you. Gluttony! Yeah, I remember playing through, I think whenever I played through Crystal, like, about a month ago. I know it was during my Secret of Mana Let's Play. I was playing Crystal, kind of following alongside my own Let's Play and Chugga Conroy's. I wound up catching a Jinx. I named her Lust. I wound up catching Snorlax, naming him Gluttony, and yeah, I just caught a few other things, and I named them, like, after the seven deadly sins. Could not use them in my party, though, because I can only use six. But anyways, we get the Super Rod from this gentleman right here. Which means now, whenever I put in the random battle encounters, I will actually start putting in what you can find with the Super Rod. Like that. Alright. And also, whenever we get the HM Surf, I'll show you what you can run into whenever you surf. Time to cut down this tree and battle this trainer right here for this item. Be right back. Not very hard at all, and you call yourself a trainer? You're a failure! I'm sorry, that was a little bit harsh. Alright, fisherman, I know what you're gonna do. I wonder if there's anything up here. Nope, nothing. Alright. Come on, don't turn around. Don't turn around. Stay facing that way. Good boy! Let's cut down this tree and see if there's anything hidden down here. Which I bet you there's not. Did not think so. Alright. You know, I just now realized that fisherman up there is like constantly turning back around. He's a failed fisherman. And I did not know that she could fight you. I thought that she just randomly walked on that bridge for no adequately explored reason. Okay, dokie then. Yeah, if you check on the ground right here, you can find a PPO. The sign that's over there on the left, if you read it, it will just basically tell you, hey, search in that spot and you'll find something good. And yeah, I just now showed you it was a PPO. Alright, moving over here. I'm gonna probably fight all these trainers off screen. Okay, I will get lost. Ah! The way that I edited that was actually pretty funny. It's just like, oh god, he's gonna battle me. No, get lost. Crap. Oh well, nah. Yeah, all the yellow haired guys on this route, they are bird keepers, I believe, which means that they use only flying types, so just use electric and you're good. Moving on. Let's go. I don't want to run into any trainers right now. I just want to go on to Fuchsia City. So that way I can go ahead and get my fifth gym badge. And seeing as how YouTube has extended the time limit to 15 minutes on every video, I'm pretty positive I can get the, soul badge. Okay, I'm sorry, that was actually kind of a bad joke. That was terrible, I apologize. Let's go ahead and talk to this 8 up here, and he will say something about catching 50 Pokemon right here, and you get the experience share. No, I have not caught 50 Pokemon. Do I look like the type of trainer who actually catches everything I see? No. All I do is just catch something and I train it for this Let's Play, and I'm pretty sure that off-camera I will try to catch 50 Pokemon for the experience share and all the other items that you could get, like the item finder. Although the item finder kind of sucks, so I don't really want that. Alright, Pokemon are all healed up and everything. It's time to go fight Koga, who is a ninja. Believe it! Alright, yeah, aside from that, all the trainers in here are jugglers. Do not be fooled. Every single one of these jugglers, I was expecting poison-type Pokemon, so like I said before, don't be fooled. Except for the tamers right there. Every single one of the jugglers use psychic-type Pokemon. Which is awkward because this is a poison-type gym, so if they all just like band together, then they can easily overthrow Koga. Wow. I'm trying to find my way through these damnable invisible walls, and there we go. Fwahahaha. I love his laugh. He just goes, fwahahaha. Yeah. Poison brings steady doom, something about poison-type Pokemon that are going to lose! Erica didn't stand a chance against me, and she used poison and grass types, okay? You're just using, like, poison types, and also a Venomoth. So you got, like, poison and bug going on there. Okay, yeah, whenever I was training up Jongo here, he finally learned Psychic. I mean, I could have very easily gone to Saffron City and gotten the TM if I was impatient, but, nah, I was patient enough. Bring it on, Muk! Muk is like a giant shit demon. Yeah, alright. Alright. Your evasiveness rose. But my psychic still hit you. So your evasiveness rising was just a complete and utter failure. Just like you, Koga. Just like you. Alright, level 37. Yeah. We're good to go here. And now we fight another Koffing. Let's go ahead and annihilate you with another psychic. I just now realized Jongo was underleveled for, like, or not underleveled. He was on a lower level than what Koga's were, and yet he's still tearing ass. There we go, Weezing. I thought that you used a Venomoth. Unless if that was just like a Janine or something like that from the Gold, Silver, Crystal, Heart, Gold, Silver, I'm not really sure. Or, no way, I remember now, you used a Venomoth in the Pokemon League whenever you become an Elite Four guy. Somehow this trainer became... Somehow or another, I don't know how, but Koga becomes one of the Elite Four. How the hell does that happen? Oh, well, he's a freaking ninja, so he can do whatever the hell he wants. And I'm an air pirate, so I can do whatever the hell I want, and I get booty. Hurry up and die already. I don't care if I'm poisoned, I can still kick his ass. Come on, Psychic. Well, actually, yeah, Psychic will kill it all. Like that. There you go. Alright, we finally beat Koga, the failed ninja. Although he's still much better than Naruto, in my opinion. Because Naruto's just annoying as hell. And now we get TM6, which is toxic. Anyways, thank you all for watching. I'll see you in part 17.